Once you've decided there's a need to implement a knowledge base, where do you start? How do you decide and prioritize what to write about? For those of you who don't identify as good writers, how do you even write the article? I'm sure these are just a few of the millions of questions running through your mind. Well, fear not. In this video, we'll go through these questions and more. We'll dissect a well-written knowledge base article to understand what makes it good, how you can emulate it, and how you can even add your own creative spin to it. But before we look at a specific knowledge base article, we need to talk about what you're even going to write about. When HubSpot started their knowledge base, in order to determine what articles they should produce, the knowledge base team combed through customer support reports to figure out trends, where agents were repeating themselves, what the most common inquiries were, and what problems could easily be solved with documentation. Additionally, the knowledge base team partnered with our implementation team to discuss what information would be helpful for folks to know before getting on a call with an implementation specialist, who is someone who walks through setting up tools and processes. Whether you work in a field similar to HubSpot's or not, partner with your customer-facing teams to determine what to write about. Creating close relationships with these customer-facing teams enables you to develop a knowledge base that prioritizes your customers' needs. All right, now that you have a general idea of what you're going to write about, let's chat about tips for writing your knowledge base articles. The most important thing you want to make sure of is that your knowledge base is optimized for readability. Readability is the quality of being legible or decipherable. There are two ways to optimize for readability: through the content itself and through how the content is presented. Let's first talk about the content itself. Knowledge base writing is all about instruction and information. That being said, you want to make sure your knowledge base articles just include the necessary content that lets your learners solve their problem. This means no personal anecdotes, no jokes, and especially no dad jokes. Make your information attainable. This means using simple language and no jargon so that anyone can understand your knowledge base content. Also, don't use slang or idioms. Since you might have international customers or customers who are not native English speakers, keep their needs in mind as well. Just as importantly, you need to present your information in a way that's decipherable. Use the same template for all your articles in your knowledge base. Learners like consistency. Answer one question per knowledge base article. Don't cram in a ton of information in a single article. Use a consistent, non-distracting text font and color. Use bullet points. It's so much easier to read a list than it is to read long paragraphs. Okay, you now know what to write about, and you have an idea as to how to optimize your articles for readability. We're ready to move on to the fun part, dissecting a knowledge base article. For this exercise, we'll go through one of HubSpot's knowledge base articles, How Do I Track Email Clicks? Let's start at the top, the title. As you can see, this title is in the form of a question. There are a couple of reasons why this is favorable. For one, most people nowadays just type in their entire question in a search engine. If your title matches what they search, your knowledge base discoverability will increase. Furthermore, titling your article in the form of a question almost forces you to stick to the one knowledge base article, one answer rule. Now, let's move on to the body of the article. Start your article off with a few sentences covering what will be covered in the article. Then, move on to the tasks the learner needs to implement. Bullet points are especially useful when you're telling your reader to do a task. Otherwise, if your task is in a paragraph, it can easily get lost in the slew of other words. Keep one task per one bullet point. If some of the tasks can be better illustrated using screenshots or GIFs or videos, use them. As you can see, this article incorporates text and screenshots. Having options in a single article makes for a great learning experience. By doing this, you're incorporating multiple different learning types. Not everyone learns the same way, so by including text and then a GIF showing what that text represents, you're making an inclusive learning environment. Also, if you include alt text on your images, you're further optimizing your article for SEO. Now, like everything else, there's a downside to adding these types of content to your articles. When it comes time to update articles, replacing videos, GIFs, and even screenshots can be a time-consuming and manual process, so do keep that in mind as you produce articles. End your article with intended outcome, as well as what your learner now has the ability to do. For instance, this article ends by reading, now that you have enabled click tracking, you can analyze your email performance in these ways. You don't need a big conclusion, just a sentence or two telling the learner what benefits they will get once they've reached their goal. And finally, all your knowledge base articles should end with the option to leave some sort of feedback. Especially when just starting out your knowledge base journey, you want to know what's working, what's not, and how to make your customers even more successful. In addition to just asking if the article was helpful, see if you can get stats on which articles are getting the most views, what the most common search topics in your knowledge base are, and how your ticket volume has changed since employing your knowledge base. Keeping your knowledge base up to date is, as we mentioned earlier, time-consuming, but necessary for your customers to have a good self-service experience. We recommend using a spreadsheet that marks all the products or main topics mentioned in each knowledge base article. That way, when a certain area of your product or service changes, you can easily do a search in your spreadsheet and come up with a list of articles that need updating. So, to sum things up, there are a couple of things you need to keep in mind when writing a knowledge base article. When figuring out what to write about in your knowledge base, consult customer-facing teams to see where you can remove pain from their day-to-day. Optimize your knowledge base for readability, the content itself, and how the content is presented. Make your title a question. Use a variety of content in your articles, bullet points, images, videos, GIFs. Give your customers a chance to give you feedback. Keep a spreadsheet documenting which articles talk about which products or topics so that you know when to update your articles. Following these tips will ensure you're off to a great start with your knowledge-based content creation. Good luck!